Welcome to the complete FPS boost and optimization guide for Warzone on your PC. This should be quite an easy tutorial. For more information, click on the first link in the description below. We will first of all go over your in-game settings. In the Graphics tab, you can preview your expected VRAM usage for Warzone and multiplayer on the bottom right. This is a good indicator when applying your display and quality settings, and you should try to lower your VRAM usage below this max line. Make sure to set your window mode to full screen. I have set it to borderless to make it easier to record. This will in any way prevent micro stutters and will help keep a better frame rate. Set your display adapter to your main GPU. Set the screen refresh rate to the refresh rate of your monitor. You can only change this setting when in full screen mode, and it will use your current display refresh rate when using windowed or borderless mode. Below, you will want to use a render resolution of 100. For low-end PCs or laptops, you might want to lower this to around 90%, which will increase your FPS by a lot, but the visual quality will suffer a lot the lower you set this. As you can see, your VRAM usage will change a lot when decreasing or increasing this setting. Next, enable the dynamic resolution option in order to allow the game to adjust your render resolution to keep a more stable frame rate I will set my target frame rate to 120, as my screen refresh rate option is set to 100. Set the aspect ratio to automatic, which will use your native monitor aspect ratio. You should make sure to disable VSync, as it can look like your frame rate will have reduced by a lot. In case you are able to utilize a high-end graphics card and reach a high frame rate, then you might want to enable this option to get a better viewing experience. Set the custom frame rate limit to custom, and then expand your FPS options. I will set my gameplay custom frame rate limit to 140, as everything above would be a waste of performance for my PC. You will want to set this option above your dynamic resolution frame rate target, but below the maximum FPS you can get. The menu custom frame rate limit should be set to around 60, and the out of focus FPS option will be set to 30 by default, which is more than enough. The brightness option will have no impact on your performance, so set this option according to your preference. When using an NVIDIA graphics card, and these last options are available to you, then make sure to enable your NVIDIA Highlights and NVIDIA Reflex Low Latency settings. When this is done, we will take a look at your quality settings. I like to use an FOV of 100 and the ADS FOV to independent, which will use the usual FOV increase when aiming down sights. When setting this option to affected, then your FOV will decrease according to your FOV setting above. Under Details and Textures, you will want to set your streaming quality and texture resolution options according to your expected VRAM usage. Especially your texture resolution will have a lot of impact on your gaming performance. Low-end PCs should run better when setting the streaming quality to normal and texture resolution to low or even very low. Set the texture filter anisotropic option to normal, particle quality to high, as it will have less impact on your performance. Bullet impacts and sprays can be enabled if you don't find them distracting, and set the tessellation option to near, which will only apply tessellation to near objects on the map. Your on-demand texture streaming setting will enable you to change how much of your network connection will be used to update your game with new textures. This will largely depend on your network connection. The default values should be fine for most users. In your post-processing effects section, make sure to set most of these options according to your preference. When using an NVIDIA RTX card, then you should make use of the NVIDIA DLSS option. When setting this option to balanced, then your GPU will help increase the performance and image quality of the game. If you want to disable anti-aliasing, then you also have to disable the NVIDIA DLSS option. So make sure to play a game and see what looks best to you. I prefer to disable the World Motion and Weapon Motion Blur settings. Under Shadow and Lighting, I like to lower the first three shadow options to a minimum. Set Particle Lighting to Normal, disable Direct X-ray Tracing, set the Ambient Occlusion option to Dynamic Objects, and finally, disable Screen Space Reflections to get the most performance. If you want to preview your CPU and GPU utilization while in-game, then I suggest using your built-in Xbox Game Bar overlay. When using the shortcut Windows Key and G, you will be able to pin this performance window anywhere on your screen, and when using the shortcut again, it will stay on your main screen. You can preview your CPU and GPU utilization in percent, as well as your VRAM and RAM usage. After applying your changes, make sure to leave the game running and open up your Task Manager by searching for it in your Start Menu search. In the Processes tab, right-click the Modern Warfare process and select to go to Details. In the Details tab, right-click the highlighted process and set its priority to High. In order to reduce the CPU utilization from other programs, I suggest you end some programs from running in the background, which you don't need when playing the game. But make sure to only end programs from running which you know won't break your operating system. In the Startup tab, you can additionally prevent programs from starting up on system boot. You can then close your Task Manager and Modern Warfare. Next, search for Graphics in your Start Menu search to open up your Graphics System Settings window. From here, under Custom Options for Apps, select Browse and your File Explorer will open up. Navigate to the drive on which you saved Modern Warfare on. Program Files, Call of Duty Modern Warfare, and here select the Modern Warfare application and click on Add. This will add Modern Warfare to this list below. When selecting options for Modern Warfare, make sure to set the graphics preference to High Performance, which in most cases will take advantage of your graphics processor to help run the game on your system. When this is done, navigate to the Gaming section. Under Game Mode, you have the option to enable or disable Game Mode on your PC. In theory, Game Mode should prevent Windows Update from performing driver installations and sending restart notifications, as well as help achieve a more stable framerate while in-game. Some users have reported that disabling this option will drastically increase their gaming performance on Windows 11 and 10. I suggest enabling this option, as it should increase your overall gaming performance. Keep your settings window open and search for Update to get to your Windows Update settings. Make sure to check for updates, and in case there is an update available to you, make sure to download it before restarting your PC, which will install the update for you. You should also make sure that your graphics card driver is up to date. I suggest using the GeForce Experience application if you're using an NVIDIA GPU, but you can also use the AMD Radeon software. In the Drivers tab, simply click on Download, and the application will automatically download and install the latest driver. Repeat this step at least a few times a year to make sure that you get the most performance out of your hardware. In the Home tab, you can access individual game settings, which can also be changed from here. Simply select Details for Modern Warfare. You will be presented with current in-game settings, and with the optimal settings suggestion depending on your hardware. When selecting Optimize, GeForce Experience will apply the recommended settings to the game. You also have the option to use custom settings when selecting this wrench icon. Here, use this slider system to reduce some options and change your display resolution and display mode in case you're using an abnormal screen resolution as I am. When navigating to your GeForce settings, make sure to disable the in-game overlay in your General Settings tab, as application overlays often cause performance issues. Below, you have the option to enable the image scaling option. For some of you, this option is not available as your graphics driver is not up to date. Enabling NVIDIA image scaling can dramatically increase your frame rate for any game you play on your PC. In case you have any further issues or problems following this tutorial, then I suggest following my extensive guide linked in the description below. I hope this helped you out. Leave a comment if you have any questions, and see you in the next one.